welcome to the Homestead. I'm in my kitchen today, but I'm not doing any cooking. I'm actually going to fill and clean my kerosene lanterns. And I'm gonna show you what we use here for our light this time of year. You'll see this one right here is a Dietz. We like these because they're a better lantern than something that you might purchase at Walmart, and they don't leak, so you won't have any problems with leaking. We've used these for 2 years now, and they're still going strong. We purchased these at a website called laymans.com, and we can put the link on the video for anyone who's interested. We purchased ours on sale for $10 each. I think the price now on there is around $20. But I still believe these lanterns are really worth it. Like I said, we've used them for 2 years straight. I'm talking pretty much every day, not so much in the summer when the days are longer, but definitely when the days are short. This time of year, the sun's starting to go down around 5 o'clock. So, you know, we're lighting our lanterns and generally using them until about 9, 9:30, 10 o'clock at night. So they're burning a good 5 hours a night. After the kids go to bed, we tend to just use one or two, and that's all the light we need after the kids go to bed. So we try to conserve on kerosene that way. Maybe we'll just burn one or two, and then maybe some candles is what we do too. This Dietz lantern is called a Blizzard, and we liked them. Number one, they were on sale when we were purchasing lanterns. But number two, I really like the blue color. I think it goes really well in my house because I have other blue things. And I'll take you over here and I'll show you what we do with these lanterns. We have these closet hooks that would be used in a closet, and the rod would be set on top of these hooks. And we installed them to hang our lanterns, and they work really well. If you're like me and you have little kids running around, you want these up and out of the way where they can't reach them, they can't bump them, run into them, whatever, throw something and knock them over. All right, this one is one that was purchased at Walmart. And if you don't have lanterns and you're just trying to get started, maybe you want to purchase something for the when the electricity goes out, or maybe there's some kind of a disaster and you want to be prepared for that. I really would recommend, if you don't have a lot of money, this is a really, really good little lantern. It provides a reasonable amount of light. The Dietz lanterns do provide more light, but these are really, really good for what they are. I think this was $8 at our local Walmart. We really, really like this, and we set this on the dresser in our bedroom because the kids don't go in there, and so I'm not afraid of this getting knocked off. So I'm just gonna walk through of how I take care of our lanterns when I need to fill them. And this time of year, since the sun is going down early, about 5 o'clock, you know, and the days are gonna get shorter and shorter before they start getting longer, I generally have to do this about two times a week. This time of year, two times a week. We go through a lot more kerosene this time of year. And so what I'm doing, I'm just removing the globes. And I'm gonna set those aside, and I'm gonna clean them after I'm done filling the lanterns. And if you've never filled lanterns before, I would suggest that you do this outside. It can be a messy process if you're not used to doing this. I have newspaper down because I do have a few little drips now and then. But when I first started doing this, I did it outside because, well, I did spill more, but I'm more experienced now. So I can do it inside without worrying about spilling all over. Okay, so I'm just taking out my wicks is what I'm doing right now. And this one just unscrews. This is actually the really, I love this little lantern. It's so simple. These other ones have a little cap that you pull off. And then this is the wick right here. So what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna show you how I trim my wicks. This actually turns right out, and I can pull the wick out from the bottom. And you see how the edge has been rounded? You don't want that. You want the wick to be straight across. So I'm gonna do that for all my lanterns. Okay, so believe it or not, this wick right here is a good length. And I say believe it or not, just because this wick has been in here for almost a year. No, maybe 6 months of good burning time. You know, when we first started preparing and we purchased our prep supplies for moving off grid, I had no idea how long one of these would last burning regularly, but they last a long, long time. If you take care of them right and make sure that you never burn your lanterns dry. If you burn your lantern dry, your wick will burn right down and then you'll have to replace your wick. So you wanna make sure that you always have kerosene in your lamps, otherwise your wick will burn right down and you'll have to replace it. I wanna cut most of this charred piece off. And I'm just gonna see how it's just kind of flaking. It's no longer really, really firm. You wanna cut into the, when you get into the firm material is where you wanna be. This is mostly ashes and charcoal on the end, so I wanna make sure all of that is cut off. Okay, and then I just kinda brush my wick out so the corners are standing straight. And then I just kinda trim those little last hairs off. And I'll do that on that side. You don't want any hairs off. It really does affect how, I mean, you don't want any hairs hanging. It affects how your flame burns. So you want it to be straight across as much as possible. It really is an art to trimming a wick. Okay, so I'm done trimming my wicks. I did want to say though that when your lantern flame starts to flicker and you have trimmed your wick, you've added enough kerosene and you think it's fine, your wick may have to be replaced. I replace mine when they're kind of like that length. So I'm going to slip my wick back in here, see from the bottom, until the teeth grab it, and then I can pull it out. And this one moves pretty good. It's not too stiff. This one, I think, may need to be cleaned. Sometimes they'll get a buildup of creosote down inside here, which is kind of like the buildup that gets in your chimney of your stove, and you have to clean that out. Well, I have this little wire brush. What I'll do is just get down in there and knock the corners off. And the reason I do that is just so the wick will turn freely up and down. If I don't do that, the wick gets stuck and it gets really hard to turn the wick up and down. Now that I've cleaned my wicks, I'm gonna fill my lanterns with kerosene. And you, on these Dietz lanterns, you have two options. You have this little hole right here. It has this cap. Or you can do it from the center hole. I usually use the center hole just because I already have my wick out. But this hole is really safer. If you want to not overfill your lantern, I would recommend using this hole. I do use this hole because my wick is out already. And I know how much kerosene this lantern will hold because I've filled it very many, many times. But for now, I'm just gonna use my center hole. And I know how much kerosene comes up the funnel, so I don't overfill it. The only advantage to these Dietz lanterns is that they have a hanger. You can get them out of the way, and they do provide a lot more light. So then I'll get my cap back on. I have to make sure that this little hole lines up. And then I just and that's how it stays in place. My last step is to clean the globes. You know, you've seen all those old-fashioned movies, you know, the old cowboy movies where they have the kerosene lantern hanging on the wall and the globe is black. I always watch those movies and kind of laugh because there is no way that they would be able to see anything if their globe is black. You don't want to keep your globe black. That really limits your light, and you're not going to have much light if your globe is filled with soot. It's really, like you can see mine right here, they are pretty clean already. There's no soot on them. And the reason that is because I know that if my flame is too high, it's gonna start to smoke. And so as soon as I light my lantern, I turn my flame way down just so it's barely peeking out above here. And then as the longer the lantern burns, the bigger the flame grows. Because if you turn your flame way up the first time you light it, your flame is gonna continue to grow and your lantern is gonna be filled with smoke and soot, and so your globe is gonna turn black. So you don't wanna do that. As soon as you light your lantern, turn your flame way down, and then in the 5 or 10 minutes or so, your flame will grow and it'll be the perfect size for your light. So what I'm gonna do, I just wipe out my globes with a wet rag. Just get anything that's lingering in there. And then I dry it with a dry rag. I used to use soap and water, but it's really not necessary. It's pretty shiny. I'll slip it back in here. Pull on the top. Line it up so it fits right down in there. This hook, I did not realize being a newbie, this hook is not for carrying your lantern. Maybe some of you don't know that. I didn't really pay attention much. But if you pick it up by here, this is only for lifting this to get the globe to slide out. This is not for carrying your lantern or hanging your lantern, because your globe will come out. This is how you carry your lantern safely. Now that I'm done cleaning the lanterns, I just want to show you the easiest way I know how to light the lantern. I turn the lantern wick up just so I can see it peeking out there. I get my lighter. There we go. Now I turn my flame way down. You see how it's just peeking up above there? And that is a really good flame. It's a really good shape of a wick. You can see a little bit of a crown on top of there, but that's a good shape for the wick. So I turned it down, and then over the course of the next 5 or 10 minutes, the flame will grow. You can see it growing already. You want to make sure you turn it down, otherwise your lantern is going to be filled with soot, and then you'll have to clean your globe and you won't have nice clean light anymore. But that is how to keep your lantern clean. Always turn your wick down right after you light it. So I hope you've enjoyed all of our tips and tricks on how to take care of lanterns. See you next time on the Homestead.
If you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button below the video. It really makes creating these videos worthwhile. If you want to make sure to never miss a new video, be sure to click the subscribe button. Now you can get your homesteading questions answered. Visit us at our contact page on anamericanhomestead.com and send us your questions. Maybe we'll pick your question for a future video or article on our website.